Now, since we lost everything, basically, I'm gonna have to find some more, I'm guessing. What is this? I wonder if there's any water around here, so we can get some of the inventory. Oh God. Am I supposed to be able to kill those? Oh God. Why is he coming after me? I'm not even doing anything. There's an egg thing. What's that? Whoa, no way. Do you think I can lure him over here? That's good to know, though. Bro, where? Why are they everywhere? No way. Yes. Let me suck you up. Wait, no, that's the healing thing, right? Maybe that's what I'm looking for. Oh, I think there's one right here. Okay, good. Maybe we can get all of them like this then. I mean, there's another one. What is that? Oh God, oh God, oh God. Oh, cool. Oh, found an egg. Hey, another win. I can have one more, I think. That'd be good. I don't know if I want to mess with that yet. Thank you. I really wish the blue thing was right here so I can get more stuff. Oh, there's another one. No, I didn't. Why did I eat that? Of course there's no more of those things. Cloud Tribe did. Okay, you can storm.
When the Trevum stepped on the strange device, an ancient memory came back to them. A memory of long ago, where the cities of their people still stood, and a fight against the cylinder was not yet lost. In those days, a very smart Trevum had found a way of cheating the cylinder, of stealing a little bit of its power to absorb and to reshape. In this way, the Trevum could revive their fallen friends, or send others to a hidden place. And it was also by this device that a link had been forged, and a path had been opened to the voice that spoke within them.
Interesting. Guess we're moving on. Wait. Okay. You motherfucker, why would you move? Is there any more of them? I need like a couple more. Oh, I see more. Well, there's two more. That's so weird. We could go through this way, maybe save though. What the hell? Okay, well, that one's dead. But there's no way I already fucked up. If not. Oh God. Go. Oh no, I think we're not gonna make it. Oh God. Go, go. Oh my God, that was so close.
cylinder roared with fury. The voice in their memory spoke with great urgency. The Trebom had to be very careful now. The cylinder would lash out at the land, but it would not let them run too far. To survive, they would have to stay in the eye of the storm.
Great, dude. He wants to kill me so bad. Whatever it is. Food right here. I'm gonna grab these real quick. Is there another one? I don't see any nests anywhere. That thing. Is he gonna do the same thing here? That'd be lame. So there's a hut up there. Come on, stop. Yeah.
As frightening and surprising as this enormous creature was, the Trebom felt a sense of relief
to see it
descend from the sky. This was the celestial being they'd been told to seek. Perhaps it held an answer to their troubles.
What?
Yeah. As they approached the colossal creature, their optimism faded. It did not seem to like them at all. And now they realized what terrible danger they were in. If this creature guarded the way to some holy place, then that place must lie below it. And being so large, the creature most likely could not see what was in front of it or beneath it. So perhaps the size of the Trebon was an advantage after all. Perhaps they could reach the platform right under the serpent's head.
Really? All right, well, I think that's going to be it for today. So if you want to see more, I'm going to be streaming tomorrow. I'm going to see...